You know, a high school teacher in Oklahoma has been found allegedly drunk in public, actually in the classroom, and with no pants on.
More breaking news. Within the last 90 minutes, a substitute teacher, police say, was intoxicated on the job, bonded out of jail.
An elementary school teacher is off the job tonight for possibly drinking on the job.
A Pinellas County teacher arrested at school. The fourth grade teacher accused of showing up to work drunk.
Virginia Beach police say a teacher showed up drunk at Plaza Middle School this morning.
A Rush Middle School teacher decides to show up to school extremely drunk. Okay, she had a blood alcohol level of 0.26.
Only on 7, a Belen High School teacher fired for allegedly drinking on the job.
Administrators tell us Kathleen Jardine could have been drunk in her classroom for hours before students turned her in.
An East Tennessee teacher is accused of being drunk at school.
A high school teacher in Chino Hills has been arrested, accused of showing up to work drunk.
Tonight, we're getting a look at the moment an Oklahoma teacher was arrested at school. Kimberly Coates, a third grade teacher in Perkins, is accused of being drunk on the first day.
Mercy, mercy, mercy. Lord have mercy on our educators. Oh, goodness. Well, first off, let's start with a thank you for being here. Glad you could join my channel today. This is another video that doesn't have anything to do with predators, but it got my attention only because of the most current case of a teacher showing up. Not only showing up, she's keeping a stash in the classroom in her juice cup. So, I had recalled many other school teacher alcohol related incidents, so I thought I'd do a little shopping around on Google and YouTube, and lo and behold, I probably picked 10% of what's out there, and I didn't even scratch the surface. And it's a sad situation. It really is. Teaching, the education system in this country, I mean, teaching must just be a depressing thing. I can't imagine what it would be like to be an educator this, you know, this day and age. I happen to be familiar with the education system in the sense that I lived with an educator for years, and it's different, and they're put through a whole lot more than a teacher should have to be put through. And I mean, I can almost see where it would, you know, the old saying, it'd drive you to drink. But we can't have our teachers showing up to work cocksuckered. Oh, mercy. Well, once again, thank you for being here. Hit that like button, subscribe, help the algorithm out, comment, all that good stuff. I have no idea how I'm going to put all this together, but I'm going to try to tie each one of these stories back in. So wish me luck. And without further ado, here we go.
You know, a high school teacher in Oklahoma has been found allegedly drunk in public, actually in the classroom, and with no pants on. Lori Hill was arrested Monday for public intoxication. Welcome back to school, kids. Now, it was the first day back for the teachers. Her co-workers found some shorts for her to wear. Come here, girl, put these on. Before she was then hauled off to jail.
When our officers interviewed her, she did admit having had some vodka yesterday morning before she came to school.
Wow. The school district would not comment, but we learned that Hill was just hired this year. Students go back to class today. I don't know if she was feeling undue pressure or what.
No pants on, huh?
Ma'am, you seem to have forgotten your pants.
Maybe she was teaching biology. I don't know.
We're not right.
More breaking news. Within the last 90 minutes, a substitute teacher, police say, was intoxicated on the job, bonded out of jail. Investigators say they arrested her at Bentley Elementary School in Sanford. That's near Reinhart Road. And that's where she was teaching second graders at the time. News 6's Justin Warmoth joins us live from the school. And Justin, did this sub have anything to say as she bonded out?
Well, Julie, she told us no comment a few times, but other than that, she was just trying to avoid our cameras. She only had an $8,500 bond, so she was able to post that before having to go in front of a judge today. Meantime, parents of students who go here to this school were not happy to hear what happened.
News 6 was there this afternoon when 52-year-old Holly Joel bonded out of the Seminole County Jail. Joel is now off the job as a substitute teacher with Seminole County Public Schools after Sanford police say she was teaching her second grade class intoxicated. The incident happened Tuesday at Bentley Elementary School.
That's amazing. Wow.
Yeah, that's scary. That's definitely scary with the kids in the classroom.
Police say a teacher at the school noticed Joel was acting strangely Tuesday morning. That teacher then told a school resource officer who went to the classroom to investigate. We're told the officer asked Joel to stand up from the desk, and when she did, she fell into a window. The officer also noted in his report that Joel smelled of alcohol and was slurring her words.
I'm in shock right now, and, you know, with all due respect, you know, I just hope that, you know, the courts prevail and they do whatever they got to do to make things go the way it's supposed to go.
The resource officer also said he found prescription pills in Joel's purse, along with a water bottle filled with an alcoholic beverage. Bentley Elementary School's principal said that at no time were any students in danger or unsupervised, but some don't see it that way.
For them to witness it in a supposedly a, you know, a pristine environment, you know, away from drugs and alcohol, because that's not the message we're trying to get across to our children.
And school board officials told me that Joel has been a substitute with the district since 2014 and passed a background check. However, in 2012, we found out that she was arrested for DUI. Coming up at 5, I'm asking school board officials how she was able to be hired with a charge like that on her record.
An elementary school teacher is off the job tonight for possibly drinking on the job. Who does that? Loudoun County police say they got a tip that Mill Run Elementary School teacher Brian Chamer was intoxicated at school. Officers found multiple bottles of alcohol in Chamer's personal items at the school. He's facing several charges, including public intoxication.
An Ellis County teacher arrested at school. The fourth grade teacher accused of showing up to work drunk. Good evening, everyone. I'm Jamison Euler.
And I'm Wendy Ryan. Thanks for joining us. ABC Action News reporter Isabel Rosales broke this story. She spoke with an officer who saw the whole thing.
This Pinellas County teacher is not only fired, she's now facing criminal charges after just 7 days on the job.
When you make that decision in the line of work that you are in, that's an automatic, like, fired, re-not hire.
ABC Action News was the first to report on Lisa Edelstein's arrest. Mom of seven, Brandy Parker, found out this morning after the district called. Her daughter is a second grader at Skyview Elementary in Pinellas Park.
Some people don't have backgrounds and they take a wrong turn in life and it catches up to them. So do I blame the school? Absolutely not.
According to arrest records, Edelstein was loud and belligerent in front of the children.
Bloodshot, watery eyes, slurring of the words. There was some rocking back and forth. Stumbling.
Sergeant Roxanne Pohl of Pinellas Park PD was called in to help campus police.
I did ask her to lower her voice. I attempted to explain that there were students in the school that we wished they not be interrupted.
She says at one point, Edelstein tried to get in her car and leave.
I was shocked, disappointed. Trust here is someone who we expect to come to school ready to teach, And unfortunately, that's not what happened this morning.
We found out Edelstein has faced disciplinary action before, part of her 30 years as an assistant teacher in Hillsborough County. We're working to find out more details. Today, Edelstein faces a disorderly conduct charge and possibly more.
What was found in her car?
Marijuana.
In Pinellas Park, Isabel Rosales, ABC Action News.
Yeah, a little bit of weed there too. That's not so good for that teacher. What do y'all think? I mean, put in the comments down there, you know, as weed becomes more and more acceptable socially and legalized by the states, and of course we know that the federal government hasn't decriminalized it yet, but the states that have, most of them that have gone with the medical marijuana, inevitably look at recreational too. I don't know how many states are recreational now, but several of them are. What's your feelings on that? What do you think? Would that be a bad thing for a teacher to be showing up the classroom stone? I personally, when I was in junior high school, knew of a teacher that indulged in that. I don't know that it took place before or during work, but I'm curious what people think on that overall. I mean, these are our kids. We certainly don't want the classroom to be, unruly, or it's a tough place anyway for teachers, and I know that firsthand, that it's a tough go, especially for middle school, pre-high school years and things like that. But several of these are elementary, second grade, third grade, fourth grade, fifth grade. That's, that to me, that would be the more enjoyable years to educate, because those little minds are constantly growing and rapidly. Adolescence would be the one I'd want to stay away from a little bit because of hormones and stuff. But yeah, I don't know. I don't know quite how I feel about it. The alcohol, certainly not. Even though alcohol's been socially pretty much acceptable for 100 years now, it's legal anyway. I have my issues with it, especially beyond casual use. Not a good thing. But
a high school teacher in Chino Hills has been arrested, accused of showing up to work drunk. It happened at Townsend Junior High yesterday. Police were called to determine if 49-year-old Clifford Harper was intoxicated while in a classroom with students. After deputies contacted the teacher and conducted an investigation, Harper was taken into custody. He was booked on charges of public intoxication and child endangerment.
Court documents say a Dallas ISD teacher made calls to a 14-year-old student and inappropriately touched her.
Fox 4's Hannah Bataa has the details from the Dallas County Jail. Hannah.
Yeah, good morning, you guys. So the teacher accused of misconduct was booked into jail here yesterday. He is a chemistry teacher at Ryan Adams High School. It's in the White Rock area of Dallas. 38-year-old Cossum Frazier is charged with having an inappropriate relationship with a student. An arrest affidavit says the sophomore girl told police the chemistry teacher called her back in February saying he was drunk and wanted to spoil her and have kids together. According to the victim's claims listed in the document, Frazier sent her money and later requested she delete her text messages. Teen let police search her phone, which they say confirmed the claims.
14 years old.
Wow. Yeah. Punished to the fullest. That's how I feel. That's ridiculous.
You just don't trust nobody nowadays.
When police interviewed the chemistry teacher, they say Frazier admitted to sending the lewd texts and being drunk when he called her. Frazier, meantime, is on administrative leave. Dallas ISD had no comment on this case. Reporting live in Dallas, outside the jail, I'm Hannah Bataa for Good Day.
The fate of a local elementary school teacher is up in the air tonight after the school board says he showed up to school drunk
and that this wasn't his first time.
According to reports, Dale Roberts, an art teacher at Hyde Grove Early Learning Center, stumbled through the halls and avoided taking an alcohol test. Channel 4's Francesca Amaker joining us live. Fran, you've reviewed the report and multiple interviews from teachers.
And they all appear to be shocked, Joy and Tarek. Now, it was behind these doors where the school board voted unanimously tonight to have Roberts suspended for 30 days.
An art teacher at this elementary school is now in hot water after reports show he showed up to school drunk. According to these documents, Dale Roberts was seen stumbling, falling into walls, and slurring his speech by several other teachers. All actions that our crime and safety analyst Gil Smith say could have put his students in jeopardy.
If they have to have all their faculties, they have to be pretty sharp and ready to deal with any situation that comes up. Some type of first aid situation or some type of fight, anything that goes on that could be a hazard in that classroom, a teacher needs to be prepared to deal with that.
But according to the report, Roberts wasn't. He was contacted by the principal, who was told Roberts could be under the influence. He denied it, only saying the night before he had 4 ounces of alcohol during the Super Bowl, along with lemon and whiskey for a sore throat. Roberts was then told to take a drug and alcohol test, but when officials went to his classroom to watch his students, he was gone, later stating he panicked and didn't want to lose his job. He also stated he'd been stressed out about his dog and his daughter, and he stated he was going through a divorce, which he compared to a death. Reports show Roberts was over the legal limit. Just 3 weeks prior, we learned he was asked to take another alcohol test and was 3 times the legal limit. Now, Smith says multiple factors will go into his punishment.
Checking his background, checking his previous work history, how long they've been employed, have they had any problems from this person in the past? So it's almost like on a case-by-case basis. But with this being the second time, they're going to have to look at this a lot differently.
So again, Roberts is now suspended for 30 days. Additionally, he'll also be required to partake in an employee assistance program to help his personal matters. I'm live tonight, Francesca Amaker, Channel 4, the local station.
All righty, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Ram fans all around the world. The next and final story will be the one that got my attention. It's the most recent, a few days old, out of Perkins, Oklahoma. And I'll probably do a couple little different takes on it here, and we'll cover that story, and that'll be the end of it. I appreciate everybody coming by. Hope that my interest are entertaining to you, and make sure to check in frequently. Hit that notification bell. Hit the like, subscribe. Help the channel out all you can. It's much appreciated. And we go live at least once a week, sometimes twice a week. And notification will let you know when that's happening. You might enjoy our live streams. Do just about everything there. Cover videos, sometimes movies, music, what have you. We'd love to have you join us. So, all right, here we go with Perkins, Oklahoma. We got a teacher here that just refuses to fess up to the fact that she was caught and they knew it, and she just tried to squirm her way out of it every which way she could. So without further ado, I'm prouder to Ram. Until the next time we meet, I be gone. Enjoy the last part of the video.
Details tonight in the arrest of a third grade teacher at Perkins Tryon Elementary. He was accused of being drunk on the first day of school.
News 4's Hunter Elise is joining us now live with a breakdown of the body cam footage from officers during her arrest. And Hunter, we also understand she's already been taken off the school website too.
Yeah, I did check the elementary school website this afternoon, and Kimberly Coates is no longer listed. The body cam footage shows that it took police about 30 minutes to talk with and then arrest her at the school on Thursday.
You're under arrest.
Please don't do this.
It's too late.
No, please, please, please.
please, I can't do this.
Those are the words Kimberly Coates kept repeating in the body cam video after she was accused of being drunk in the classroom on the first day of school. The conversation started like this, with Coates in a room answering questions from Superintendent Doug Ogle, another staff member, and a police officer.
Do you have a prescription for anything that maybe you have taken today that just seems like you're not the same person that I talked to this morning?
I did take some medication last night to help me with sleep because I have some anxiety stuff.
But staff and police weren't buying it and asked Coates to take a breathalyzer test.
Are you going to blow double zeros?
I don't know.
You should know. If you hadn't drank anything, you should blow zeros. If you drank something recently, it's going to show it. How much you had to drink?
The test found Coates was three times the legal limit. That's when her story started to change. She told police she had drank wine the night before, then said she had drank wine until 3 in the morning, and finally, she admits she drank as she drove to class.
I just don't believe you right now. I think you're lying to us.
Okay, I drank on the way to work.
Up to this point, police were giving Coates the option to have someone pick her up and take her home rather than arresting her. But a few minutes later, the superintendent comes back to the room with a cup taken from her classroom.
Okay, no more games, right?
Yeah.
What is in that?
My juice.
Gonna try again? That there is wine.
Finally, the officer's patience wore off after Coates tried wiping the wine out of her cup.
Please, please, please just let me. Can we?
Hey, I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it. You had your chance, to be honest.
Well, I did.
And then you wipe this out. Put your hands behind your back.
Please don't do this. Please, I just want to talk to you. Can you just talk to me?
Put your hands behind your back.
Coates was taken to the Payne County Jail. We know she's been booked and released. The Perkins Tryon School District is conducting its own internal investigation.
All right.